I work for the Ground Systems Development and Operation Program, or also known as GSDO, which is the program that is developing all the infrastructure where we're going to launch the space launch system that is going to take humans to destinations such as asteroids or Mars in the future. So my role here as part of this program is to do cross-program integration. I work with the other centers that are developing the hardware, such as the actual rocket and the Orion space capsule. So I'm responsible to making sure that we're cooperating as far as like any type of technical issues, whenever there's any problems that they have interfacing with our program. I'm responsible for doing some of that coordination and specific items that relate to the ground. When I was a little girl, I always dreamed of working for NASA. I thought NASA was the coolest thing out there, and actually dreamt of being an astronaut. I thought that's something, you know, that I wanted to do. I wanted to explore space. So obviously quite there, I'm not an astronaut, and you know, life has changed quite a bit, but I love being an engineer for NASA. When I went to high school, one of my goals was like, you know, get interested in science and math, so I joined the astronomy club. I was very inclined to do, you know, like the STEM field, science, mathematics, and I went and asked my high school counselor what would get me to work for NASA, and she told me, well, definitely engineering. So I went ahead and did aerospace engineering. I was like, just maybe having the space in the title will get me to work for NASA. And certainly enough, I ended up with a degree on aerospace engineering. One of the memories that I have when I was a kid that kind of, I feel like, inspired me to like space or like want to be involved in space exploration. I remember like hanging out with my cousins and laying down looking at the stars. And I thought that, you know, it's magnificent what, you know, our universe, what else is out there, you know, just kind of think that we are not, I don't know, that we're the only planet that has life. I'm sure there has to be something else out there that is worth exploring, is worth sending humans to. So it really kind of like drove my obsession to start like, you know, wondering about space, wanting to learn more about space, wanting to learn about the stars, wanting to learn about astronomy. So, I believe that moment was probably what, you know, got me inspired to pursue and work for space-related industry. The advice that I will give, like, little girls out there, it's that, they should pursue their dreams, obviously. I think I can test that from my own experience, that if they follow what they want to do, they can do whatever. It doesn't matter whether they're a girl or a boy. Also that science is very interesting and it's fun. Everything that we do is, you can apply principles of physics and math and they don't even realize it. I will encourage them to, you know, go beyond of, you know, playing with princesses and, you know, doing stuff that typical girls do, and, you know, give it a shot to Lego. See how much fun you can have building something, and think that, you know, that's what engineers do. They build stuff. Or you can be an architect, or, you know, you can even be baking and you're applying concept of chemistry, just mixing different stuff. So it's important for me to encourage little girls to pursue math and science, because I think it's very important. I think the future really, our future depends on them. Being a woman in this field, I thought I had a lot more challenges. I mean, the school where I went to school, I think the ratio of women to men was like 1 to 7. So I kind of almost, I want to say, kind of got accustomed of being, you know, the only girl or woman around, just a lot of, in a field that is like dominated by men. But like working here, I really don't feel the difference. I feel like I'm treated the same way as everybody else. And sometimes I don't even think about it. Like every once in a while, like I'm the only woman in a room, and you know, it's a whole meeting full of men, but it doesn't matter. They all treat me with respect my voice, and they know that I'm technically competent to answer or deal with whatever issues I have, so I don't feel that I have a disadvantage in the field. Hopefully we will launch in 2017, a few years from now, and I think it's going to be very exciting. It's probably going to be a very emotional moment because, I mean, I've been working in this program since the beginning. So, and just to know that I have contributed to it, you know, it would be, it's something that I've been contributing since the beginning. You know, it's not something that I came and jump in right halfway through, you know, so it's going to be very emotional, very excitement to know that I was part of that.